Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. In today's video, we're going to look at how you can create glossy texture text effect in Photoshop. So we'll be creating this effect in very simple steps. The first step we're going to do is to create the texture in Photoshop, and then we'll use this texture and apply it to a text using the clipping mask option. So let's begin the designing process. The first step we're going to do is to open a new Photoshop document. So open a new Photoshop document. Let's select this one and create. Let's extend the width a little bit. So using the crop tool, I'll just extend it with the alt pressed from both sides and enter. Now let's fill this up with black color. Alt backspace or command backspace. Now the first thing I want to do is to apply our background color with a little gradient. So I'll use the gradient option. So select that and choose the gradient. And under gradient, we'll choose this one, black and white, for two color. And for the first color, let's choose black. And for the second color, we'll choose little dark color. So I'll choose this dark red faded color and click OK. And then we'll change this style to radial. And let's place this around here. And we'll reverse this so that we get that lighter portion over here and place it around here. And click OK. So our background is ready. Next step is to create the texture. And so to create the texture, we need a brush. And because we're going to create this spherical design in the texture, as you can see, if I just unclip this, you'll see that this is a texture we are going to create. So to create this texture, the first step is to create this spherical design. And to create that, let's create a brush. So I'll add a new layer, and using the ellipse tool, let's select the ellipse tool over here, elliptical marker tool, and click and drag and create a circle. Now using this, we'll apply a gradient color. So select the gradient tool, and over here, select this gradient, choose radial and click and drag and apply it. So make sure that black color is inward and the lighter is outward. If it's not, you can just reverse it like this and then apply it and it will be reversed. For me, it's fine. So I'll just click and drag and it's applied. And what I'll do over here is I'll just go to gradient and let's change this to light gray color and then click OK. Now click and drag to apply the gradient and here it is, it's applied. And command or control D to deselect. And now let's change this to brush. And to change this into brush, I'll just hide out all the background layers and then I'll go to edit and define brush preset. And here let's give it a name, anything name, like let's say sphere or a circle, S-I-R-C-L-E circle, and then click OK. So now our brush is ready. I'll just hide this off and if I select the brush, let's add a new layer, and if I select the brush, I can draw this. Now let's do some settings with the brush because we need an effect like this. And to create this effect, we want to do a brush setting under brush attribute panel. And so to do that, let's go to our option here, brush settings, and let's do some setting with the brush. So the first step is to, under brush div, let's keep the spacing around 25%. So I'll keep it around 25 and I'll go to shape dynamics and increase the shape zero to size zero to 100%, and I'll set the minimum diameter around 7-8 and check this flip X zero and flip Y zero so that it will give you this effect. If I draw it out, you can see here's our effect. So it's looking good. We need to do more stuff. So I'll go to scattering and let's add some scattering. So I want a full scattering around 300 or 350. Let's keep it around 350 and let's check it out. It's looking good. And I'll increase the zero count to 100%. So this will give you some interesting effect. And after this, I'll go transfer, and here we'll do some settings with the opacity. So set the opacity zero to 100%. This will give you that interesting opacity effect over there. So just apply it. And after that, under here, we'll set the flow to 100%. And after that, last thing is to keep it smoothing. And I'll again go back to shape dynamics and do some settings. So here, instead of off, you have to change to pen pressure and this small to big effect like that. So now all the settings are done. We want to create that design. So I'll just click and drag. So I'll just lower the shape of the brush and just draw it out like this and around like this. And you have to make sure that it's not too much. It has to be balanced because I have used very few spheres over here. So make sure that you apply a few spheres design. Let's go back to setting again and I'll do some settings here. I'll just increase the spacing so that we get some lesser number of spheres. So I'll keep it around 40 and let's check out the effect. So I'll just draw it out like that and something around like that. So here it is. Find a design which you like. I think this looks good. I'll keep it like that. The next step we're gonna do is to create a duplicate of this, and I'll use this layer for color dodge. So I'll just group this up, Command or Control G, and let's apply it a color dodge, and we'll reduce the fill value a little bit. You can see the effect. I'll reduce the main layer opacity as well so that we can see some little bit of glossiness like that. Now the next step is to add a light streak. So if you check out our design, you can see some light streak here going on. So to create that, we'll use a selection tool, rectangle selection tool, and draw a rectangle like this and apply a gradient color to it. So we'll select the same color, the gradient color. We'll choose this one and I'll create a new layer on top and we'll apply it to that new layer. So click and drag and create a white and blue. So the white should be a little lesser and black should be more. So I'll just click and drag from little upper and keeping it like that. Maybe a little bit more lesser. After that, Command Control D. Then let's convert this into smart object. And now we'll change this blend mode to color dodge. And we'll reduce the fill value, maybe around 70 to 80, so that you can get that streak effect. And if you move around, you can see the effect directly on your sphere. So it looks good. We'll keep it like this. I'll create another duplicate of it, and I'll just change the angle. So I'll just click and drag, and I'll just give some angular effect over there. I'll reduce the opacity so that we can see some cool design over there. And I'll create one more duplicate, rotate it, and place it around here. On the duplicate, I'll just increase the opacity so that we can see that effect over there. Just keep it medium, and I'll create another duplicate of it, place it over here, and we'll keep it around here. For this, I'll reduce the opacity so that we can match it with our background. So once your streak effects are applied, the next step is to apply the color. So let's apply a gradient color to the overall design. So I'll go over here and choose a gradient color, and let's choose some interesting color. So I'll choose this color, and let's give some color to this. So the first color I'm going to apply is red. So I'll choose a dark red color. The second color I'm going to choose is green. So I'll choose a green color, little green like this, and click OK. The third color is yellow. So I'll choose a yellow color, and let's apply some yellow color. And last one is a blue color. So let's apply some blue color, light blue like that, and OK. And now let's edge the scale. So let's lower the scale so that we can see this corner color inward. So I'll just make sure they're coming inward. And I'll change the angle to around like this, and let's reduce it a little bit more and click OK. Now after this, we'll change the blend mode to soft light, and this will apply the color to our design. And if I check out, you can see some interesting effect. You can go around with different blend modes, but you'll find that soft light gives you the perfect color. We can anytime go back in there, play around with the position of the color. So I'll just do some settings. This red, I'll just increase the brightness a little bit so that we can see that color over there. And for the blue, I'll keep it, let's check out with different color tones like that. And okay, so we'll keep it to this color. And for the green, I will keep it some fresh color so that we can see the effect over there. And we'll keep it like that. And now after that, just click OK. And here is our design. Now next step is to give some texture to our design. So if you check out over here, I have given some mesh texture over here, and to create that I have used halftone effect. So I'll go add a new layer. Let's fill this up with any color. Let's apply it with white color, and now go to filter gallery, and here you'll find that halftone pattern. So if I zoom it out, it's already applied. You can choose from dotted to lines or circles. So for our design right now, I need the dotted ones, and we'll just play around with the size. So I'll choose a medium size like this and click OK, and here is our texture. So this is the pattern. We're going to give some effect to this. So first of all, I'll change this to color dodge, and now I'll go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and we'll increase the blurness, and you'll find a nice blending between the designs. So let's keep it around. Well, we want to see those details, so I'll just lower the blurness a little bit like that and click OK. And after this, what we'll do next is will create a merged image. And over here, if you check out, something is going off. Here you see some brightness which is not giving you the true color, so we'll just try to adjust that. So I'll select these streak effects and reduce the opacity a little bit, and after that I'll again go back this highlight and okay this one. And I'll reduce the opacity a little bit so that we can blend it nicely like that. We'll add this color dodge also, and I'll just reduce it a little bit more. And after that, let's select all these streaks effect and let's try to increase the opacity. And I think this looks good. Now the next step we're gonna do is to use the shortcut Shift Command Alt E, and this will create a merged image, and we can do some settings with this. So I'll just create a duplicate of this and change this to screen, and we'll go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and increase the blur value. So let's give it around like this. Okay, and I'll reduce the opacity to around 50% so that we can nicely blend it with the background. Now after this, we'll do one more shortcut like that to merge the overall design. Shift Command Alt E, and here's our final design. Now let's add our text. So I'll choose the text tool, T for text, and let's type our text. Before that, let's add a background. So I'll just create a duplicate of this background color and place it on top of it. And here's our background color, and on top I'll type our text. So Command Control T, scale up the size, and the text I'm going to use is, it's more, so it's a thick bold font, so I like this one. I'll just type our text, space action, space action, and I'll just make sure that they are properly aligned. So we'll just use these alignment options over here, so just keep it like that, and let's place it around here. Now to apply the texture to this, I'll just place this design on top and just with the opera just clip it to our text, and you see the effect directly on our text. You can just move around the design and the texture as per your requirement. And what more we can do is we need to do some settings with the text. So double click on the text, and under layer style panel, first thing we're going to add is drop shadow. So this is for the background. So let's set the opacity to 75%, give a 90 degree angle or around any angle, it's fine, but we'll keep it around 90 degree so we can get that straight line shadow. And we'll increase the size so that we can see over here some dark shade at the background like that. We'll add inner shadow. Inner shadow will give you some interesting cool effects. So what it does is add some edge glow to the text. So to do that, first thing we're gonna do is to change the blend mode to color dodge and apply white color. Instead of black, choose white, and let's increase the distance. So increase the distance a little bit like that, and using the size option, just to drag and make it softer. So we'll just increase a little bit of choke option, and what it does is it intensify the effect a little bit more. So if you want to give a little intense color, you can do that. I'll keep it around 5. And one more thing I need to add is the inner glow. So inner glow will give you a glossy look to your text. So what I did over here is I changed the blend mode to soft light and added a white color. And after that, the opacity is full. You have to make sure that, and make it softer and keep it to the center. Now what I did over here is I adjusted the choke and the size. So let's increase the choke a little bit. So before that, let's increase the size. You see the effect directly. So I'm increasing the size and it's in the center of the text. So we'll keep it around, and I'll just increase the choke a little bit, and it will darken the outer side as well. So it gives you a glow at the center, and at the edges, it's the normal color. So using the choke and the size gives some interesting cool effect over there, like glow effect there. And after that, just click OK, and here is our effect. Now make sure that your texture layer is converted to smart object so that we don't lose the details. And after that, let's transform this to Command Control T, and let's scale down the size a little bit and just rotate it to get a perfect color for your design. So we'll keep it around like this and just move around until you get an interesting color effect, and enter. And now if you want to add a little bit more changes to this, you can anytime go inside the layer style effect and just go in there and do the adjustments. Like you want to give some edge, sharp edge over there, you can just give that. And this is also a cool effect to your text, so you can do that. But I want to keep it soft, so I'll keep it around 10, 4, and click OK. And this is the final result. The last step we can do over here is to add a little interesting design in the background, like giving us some background effect, and it will intensify our text design. So let's do that. I have got an image for a background. So here is our image. I'll just drag and drop it to a file, scale the size a little bit, enter, and I'll just place it below our text, and let's clip this to our text. And to give this interesting effect over here, as you can see, I have added some blurness to the background and added a color tint. So let's do that. So I'll just select this and go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and increase the blur value. So let's increase it like this. We are giving it a full blur, nice space effect over there, and I'll click OK. Now to add a little color tint, I'll just double click on this and open the layer style panel. Over here, click satin, and this will help you add a color tone to your design. So I'll just choose some color. Let's choose some greenish one from here, a little darker, but as well as a little bit of red tone to the background, and then click OK. So here's our design. I'll just increase the size of our background. So let's increase the size, enter, and let's select our text as well and increase the size a little bit. So just increase it with the alt pressed, and we'll just play around with this texture, rotate it until you are satisfied with the color combination and the overall look of the design. So let's keep it like that. And finally, to give a good touch to this, we'll add a lens flare. And to add that lens flare, let's add a new layer on top, fill it up with black color, make sure that it's black, alt backspace, okay, black color. Now we'll go to filter and render and lens flare. Under lens flare, you got four options. One is 50 by 300 millimeter zoom. So all three of these lens flare effects are really good, but for this design, I'm gonna choose this one. There's a blue and orange effect. This is perfectly for our text. So I'll just click, and here is our lens flare. So we'll change the blend mode to screen so that we can apply it over here and just move around and place it somewhere where you find it interesting. So I'll just place it around here, and to give that faded look at the edges, I'll just add a mask, and with the brush tool selected, let's choose some brush, soft brush over here. So let's choose this soft brush, increase the size, and let's paint it over here. Just make it a little softer over here as well, and at this corner and at this corner. So we are left with the highlight only. So here it is. If you check out over here, it's there and it's the same, but as you can see, there is some color combination which is needed to be corrected. So you can anytime go in there, just lock this up, we'll just select this texture and just go in there and just play around with it, and until you get that final nice effect like that. And let's increase the reduce the opacity of our background as well, so that we can get that dark background like that. So this is how you can create this effect. It's very simple. We have used very simple techniques to create this effect. The texture preparation technique was very simple, and we have learned few stuff in this tutorial. The first thing we have learned over here is you can use half tone effect to create some interesting texture for your design. If you have a ready-made texture, you can directly apply it to your text. Just add these cool effects and it will look like it's the texture of your text. And I think it's the simplest way to create this effect. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing like this, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel.